buck too much. Start seeing if they remember how to bend their heads.
So this is Heartland Road Show by Heartland Blackhawk, who of course is a son of Mr. Hawkeye. So we're going back to the Tijuana tribute line in this pony. Tom, is there ever a point where you let these ponies down completely for a while, or are you always doing something with them?
Once September, October rolls around, most of them go out to the field. Then they come back up in January, they put shoes on, and then they either run a lot out here during the day, two or three of them together, or on icy days, they turn loose in your arena for half hour, hour, let them run and play together. But most of these get about 6 months on and 6 months off.
And you will turn the show ponies out in pasture?
Yep, they all go out together. We got one field up there, and they go out there. Usually about the 1st of October, stay out till the 1st of January. Hey, look. Go out there on a cold rainy day, and all those other ponies be standing in them run-in sheds eating hay, and the show ponies be out running around. It's kind of funny to see. Have a good time. These things kill down.
You turn them out there, quick?
Yep. Yeah, we pull their shoes. The only problem with doing that is you got one that needs more foot, or get one that gets poor, or one that gets too healthy out there. Right. That's the only problem with it. You gotta keep an eye on that.
So as you can see here in the main barn, of course it's a big open driving arena, but then it can be closed off on both sides to make it into a bull ring. Both ends had of a gate, and it's closed off to make a nice round bullpen. Again, for you learners, this is a pony just put back to work this week. So, no chains or anything. He's just getting back into shape. Take note of the way he's the long lines are set up on him.
Seven, I guess. But he's a cowtail. He's worn for us quite a bit. Mary shows him the amateur cowtail.
All right, so we've got Vern Houston now, and Vern offers the chosen one in tonight's auction sale. Now, Vern, you've had him you bred him and raised him, obviously.
Right.
You've had a number of foals over the years. What would you say are the common traits that a person would expect to get from a chosen one foal?
Athletic. They're athletic animals type of thing. They may not be the most the extreme neck, but they're very usable. Very usable as far as working with them. Good to break and things of this sort. Good natural motion on them. Not a lot of you know, artificial to them. But they'll go out there and they'll give you what they got type of thing.
Now, would you say that a lot of his foals are the type that look good not only in hand but do look, go on and look good in harness?
Yep. And they're, you know, either way, we've shown both ways his stuff. In the last few years, we've concentrated more on the harness type stuff. And we haven't bred them to a lot of mares, but what we have bred have turned out good. I don't really remember a colt that wasn't workable or didn't turn out to some extent type of thing. Last year we had a three-year-old pleasure point we showed eye to him, and did really well, and she was just there all the time for us. No gimmicks to her, whatever, just good, honest type working horses.
Now, do you have lots of young stock if people were to come by your farm and have a look?
We got I'm sitting right now with way too many. I got 6 2-year-olds, and number 6 on the list is almost as good as number 1 on the list type of thing. And really an outstanding group of 2-year-olds back when I was foolish, when I retired. Bred too many mares type of thing, and it's been hard to separate any of them, so that's where we're concentrating on really is for next year. And I'm going to show one of the 2-year-olds in hand this year just to get one out type of thing, but they all show that athletic capability.
He's a beautiful pony, folks. I remember Vern bringing him up to Canada as a 3-year-old. I took a picture of him, which I was very proud of. Truly unique, and out of Black Princess, who was a 3-year-old world champion at the National Fraternity back in 1993, and I remember that because that was the first time my dad and I had ever went to Louisville. We were up in the cheap seats, and I believe it was Fitz's Wild Orchid with Dr. Ron got by you, but your mare was gorgeous that night, and so be sure to have a look at the chosen one in the auction, and if you're ever in the Michigan area, be sure to look up Vern Houston. He's got a whole barn full of great young ones by the chosen one, so thank you very much, Vern.
Thank you.
Here's Handsome Harry, cooling out after his workout this morning. Beautiful stallion, son of Twin Willows Handsome Dan.
We don't do much of that here.
Is this Lightning Strike, Tom?
This is Regal's Lightning Strike. Josh Beard could lock mine real good, actually. He just started back to work this week, so I just put him in harness. So he's ready to drive.
World Grand Champion Road Pony, Regal's Lightning Strike LF.
I keep on thinking I should be doing some work, but then I walk outside and say, no, I'm going back inside.
Wait, oh. Yeah.
This is how Tom Lowry trains ponies. He's texting and yeah, that's that's Simpsonville multitasking right there.
It's easier to do it when you're doing this than when you're driving.
I think he's unfriending me on Facebook as we speak.
What'd you say, unfriending?
Unfriending, yeah.
You're clogging up my timeline.
Because I grew up watching these ponies. It's kind of how we got involved in Hackney's. Was watching the videos from the 80s of Dream Boy against Flamethrower and Poinsettia's Reality against Tijuana Princess. We have a video at home of Mary showing Perfect Impression.
I remember being a kid. Before they ever showed Green Boy, they brought him to Illinois State Fair, and they were long lining him one morning, and I was there with my dad, and we were watching John and Bell long line him, and he could only trot about this high, and said, my dad, he said, this bone's going to be a good one someday. And my dad said, oh yeah? And just kind of left it at that. And they got done working them, and we were walking over to get something, some breakfast. And Dad said, you think that's going to be a good one? And I said, well, you're going to have to try a little higher. Excuse me for a second, this is my snowplow, man. Yeah. What do you say, E.T.? Do you? Okay. Well, thank you. Thank you. All right. So you think we can get a few more people parked in there now? Yeah. Did you go out and talk to the motel people, get your car for next year? Yeah, they said they didn't follow up there. The guy they got called off to file for the city or something, and he didn't come do it. They were in the crapper for a while. So, yeah. All right. Well, thank you, sir. I appreciate it. Brother-in-law went up and plowed out the fairgrounds a little for me this morning. Had a little party.
Yeah, there'd be more cars there tonight than there were last night.
Yeah.
Which one is this, Tom?
This is the Lone Ranger.
Okay. Oh, you won Kansas City with him last year?
Yeah.
Okay. Where'd he come from?
He came from Dan Lights.
Okay.
I went up there at Christmas time and saw him. Thought this was going to be easy money because he was something. Ashley and Don were up there at that point, and I called Jeff and told him we had to have him. And he said, we'll put him on the truck and bring him home. And I got home and everybody liked him, and he had a rough three-year-old year, just wasn't big and strong enough, and he got bigger and stronger and bigger and stronger, and he finished up the year pretty good for us last year, so he just started back to work this week.
So he's five now?
He's five. We'll probably county fair him so we can show quite a bit this year with him, get him in the ring quite a bit. And then, and he's got the kind of attitude that would work out good for a county fair pony. You got to show him eight times, and you got to have one that likes to go to the horse show. And he seems to like to go. So.
Now, what was that like for you winning a UPHA Classic Championship at Kansas?
It was a big deal.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie, it was a big deal.
Yeah.
I think the UPHA Classics is. I think the four-year-old ponies are the most fun because you broke them out when they're three, but they're still learning all year. And when they're four, they kind of know everything, and you can start putting those finishing touches on them.
Mm-hmm.
And you can show them in limit classes, you can show them in junior classes, and you can show them any way you want to go. And I think then the classics are kind of a big deal. And Thursday night out there at Kansas City, in my thought, is probably the best night of horse showing there is, because people are excited about the young horses, and so I think that's probably the most exciting night there is. And to go out there and be able to win a class, it's a big deal.
Highlight of your career to this point, then?
It's a pretty big deal. Mm-hmm. I don't know. There's probably a few other things. I mean, American Flyer was probably the highlight of my career, just being able to work him. But Kansas City, pretty big deal. Winning that classic out there, that's a big deal. So, and then just take one pony out there, sit around there all week. You know, I started getting pretty nervous on Thursday night. I was like, we got to do good.
Boy. Long time to think about it.
Yep. Hey, how are you guys?
Good.
We'll get it ready for you.